story to tell. The Tupolev Tu-95 bear has proven to be a successful strategic bomber for many years by the Soviet Army. For maritime reconnaissance and anti-submarine warfare, the Tupolev Design Bureau developed the Tu-142 based on this Tu-95. Formerly operated by the Soviet Navy and Ukrainian Air Force, the Tu-142 currently serves with the Russian Navy. In response to the American Polaris program, the new US ballistic missile submarines, in 1963, development of the Tu-142 began. The new Tu-142 was built on a Tu-95 airframe and fitted it with sensors from the Air 38 maritime patrol aircraft. The Tu-142 differed from the Tu-95 in having a stretched fuselage to accommodate specialized equipment for its anti-submarine warfare and surveillance roles, a reinforced undercarriage to support rough fare capability, improved avionics and weapons, and enhancements to general performance. The Tu-142's capability was incrementally improved while the TAF was in service, eventually resulting in the Tu-142MC, the final long-range Tu-142 with highly sophisticated combat avionics and a large payload. The first flight of the Tu-142 was made on July 18, 1968 and officially introduced in December 1972. Its former operators were the Soviet Union, Ukraine and India, and at present, only the Russian Navy Aviation Force remains. Tu-142 is operated by a crew of 11 to 13 people, depending on the mission. It measures 53.08 meters in length, wingspan is 50 meters, height is 12.12 meters, its empty weight is 90 tons, and maximum takeoff weight is 185 tons. The aircraft is powered by four Kuznetsov NK-12MP turboprop engines with 14,795 horsepower each, powering the 8-bladed contra-rotating constant speed propellers. The Tu-142 can reach a top speed of 925 km per hour, a cruise speed of 711 kilometers per hour, a combat range of 6,500 kilometers, and a service ceiling of 12,000 meters. The Tu-142 is equipped with various search sensors, including a search radar and sonar buoys. The original sensors were carried over from the Air 38 maritime patrol aircraft, though some of the elements were newly developed. Eventually improved versions of the Tu-142 were fitted with more capable sensors. Magnetic anomaly detection system was added on an improved Tu-142M version. to expand the range of activities. Tu-142 is fitted with in-flight refueling probe. Still, though this maritime patrol aircraft could reach US shores without in-flight refueling, it can be used for anti-submarine warfare, anti-shipping, reconnaissance, electronic intelligence, search and rescue, and other roles. The Tupolev Tu-142 inherited two large weapon bays of the Tu-95 bomber. This maritime patrol aircraft can carry a whopping 11,340 kilograms of ordnance, including anti-submarine torpedoes, depth charges, and mines. For self-defense, this aircraft is fitted with two 23mm twin-barrel cannons at the rear. In total, about 100 Tu-142s were produced. The modern Russian Navy is still operating the Tu-142 in limited numbers, about 22, and will be modernized with a new bombing system. My video about Tupolev Tu-142 answer. Thank you for watching. If you find this video interesting, please give me your thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to support the channel. Goodbye and see you again in the next videos.